Hi. By the mid-1700s, the heliocentric model had been verified and validated in several different ways. Originally, with the observations of Galileo that Jupiter had four moons and the phases of Venus showed that Venus is indeed orbiting the Sun, these were incompatible with geocentric models. So the models of Ptolemy were ruled out, for instance. James Bradley discovered two things, both showing that the Earth moves. One is the aberration of starlight, which is the Earth's motion at a constant speed of light cause a tiny shift in stellar positions over the course of a year. So as the Earth moves around the Sun, telescopic observations of stars indicate they are slightly shifted when the Earth is moving in one part of its orbit as opposed to another part of its orbit. And this was explained by Bradley that since the light is moving at a constant speed, but not infinite, the shifting of the positions of the stars would occur in this manner. Another thing that he observed was the nutation of the Earth's axis, which is a wobble caused by the gravitational pull of the Moon and the Sun, which is a variation in the rate of precession over an 18.6 year cycle. So the precession cycle that takes 26,000 years has a slow rate of change over a period of 18.6 years caused by the gravitational pulling of the Sun and the Moon on the Earth. And so the axis of the Earth has a nutation or a wobble that is evident in watching the stars in their precession, seeing that the precession rate changes over that cycle of 18.6 years. And so that was observed. Both of those strongly indicate that the Earth is moving. And so the premise of the geocentric models that the Earth is not moving is shown to be, again, false, because the Earth is moving in several different ways. The other thing is that Halley's Comet returned in 1758 as predicted. So science was beginning to really show its power of prediction, and these orbits and this kind of thing began to think about as kind of a clock that could be counted on as a timekeeping device. And another thing is the first observation of stellar parallax by Bessel in 1838 for the nearby star 61 Cygni was very significant in showing that the long predicted idea of stellar parallax, predicted all the way back in the times of ancient Greece, that if the Earth orbited the Sun, the positions of stars would shift because we're viewing them at different angles, which is a phenomenon called stellar parallax, and that stellar parallax was not observed no matter how careful observations were made. And even with the telescope, it took over 200 years for those careful observations to be made on the right star. It have to be a nearby star to show that at different times of the year, the star was seen at a different position in the sky because of the Earth's orbit around the Sun specifically. And that again showed that two very important things, that that we do, that the Earth is moving, it is orbiting the Sun. That's a confirmation of that. That, but also the distance of those stars was able to be measured in terms of the distance between the Earth and the Sun. And that was a very dramatic discovery because it resulted in showing that stars are very far, much further away than the Sun. And that's why parallax was not observable by the ancient people. William Herschel, in the late 1700s, 1781, discovers Uranus. And this is an image of Uranus with a modern telescope, an 8-inch telescope. And you can see that it has this green kind of tint. And it is not stellar looking with a large enough telescope. We can see that it is has a disk like Jupiter and Saturn, although much smaller. And this is a replica of the telescope that William Herschel used for the discovery of Uranus. Well, the 1800s found on January 1st, in fact, 1801, Ceres was discovered. And it's the first and largest asteroid, and now is considered a dwarf planet. In fact, much of the material in the entire asteroid belt is in this one asteroid, Ceres. And when Ceres was discovered, it was proclaimed as really a new object, a new comet, maybe. And but after a while, it was determined it didn't really have the fluffy comet coma that is found with normal comets. But this is, comets were something that had been discovered and they before this, and but this seemed to be definitely a new object. It really could be thought of as a new planet. But really, before much thinking could be done, other objects were found, and probably the idea that new objects could be found. If one was discovered, maybe there were more out there. And Pallas was discovered only a year later. Juno in 1807. Vesta was discovered, so there were four. All of these were between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter.